What was it?
This is from Boston. No, I mean about the Boston concert, the picture.
I haven't looked yet through my whole mail, but probably it's there. Where was it going to be? In
the Jordan Hall.
Jordan Hall. Hmm?
Right?
Big thing.
Jordan Hall is not too
big. No, I mean this. We have arranged.
Oh.
Yeah, we're here with all the people my father knows in Boston.
Mm-hmm.
It should be very cool concert.
Mm-hmm. Fun.
No matter what I do, the audience will be enthusiastic.
Do you have that?
No.
No matter what I do, the audience will be enthusiastic. It's true.
Or do you have that?
Do you want your edition?
Yes, it's...
I have an extra.
No,
the first one was very funny. He insisted. He had played it many times with Leonie Ambrose. Supposed to be an expert version.
Uh-huh.
See, so he didn't like the way I played it. He said it was too romantic. Not, the word was gut bucket. He did not.
Gut?
Gut bucket. Gut bucket is a kind of string bass. Gut bucket. So we had a lot of fights. He's very pompous. He even said, when I come back to Florida next time, you'll meet with me. You'll show me go through the score again. So they were in the reviews. And people backstage were all commenting on how different my approach was and how much they liked it. And he said it was erotic, more erotic than usual. So he started sending people over to me to tell me that they liked the approach much, you know, they liked the new approach so that he could take credit for it. He sent them over to
me.
And then I had to go to him and say, you know, you really helped me a lot. People really liked it.
Conductors. Most ego inflated people in the world. Except a few. This new conductor, the new Israeli conductor that played with him, mentioned to both countries. Thank you. Hmm? Well, it is to get out of it, but still.
Yeah.
Staccati must be a little short, and the theme, and yes, and then in the adue, the staccati in the left hand are not written, but you have to do the same thing as the same thing, and in the of course in the atre where it has a bow, there you don't. But no. Yes. But I would even there, do the two bars before that, also staccato. The E flat, yes.
A short.
There you could do that. No. Then you could do the other thing because of the many legato bits there.
Dots,
yes. That's one thing. Then, yes. In the whole thing, you see, it's just, it's too tame. What about the sound?
The sound is too soft.
Yes, we better open the piano. Wouldn't you? I mean, like to open the piano because it sounds.
But we have the tendency to play the two and a two too soft.
The piano. Loud in the concert, make the people jump out of their seats. The same thing with the 3B flats. Everywhere. I mean, for instance, you play them strongly in the first section, and then in the adieu it was already much too weak. And the same thing in the atre. In the quattro was more or less much better. And then you see this. You didn't stop between these sections. You must go one into another, and sort of münden, how do you say? That's sort of like that. I mean, when you reach the theme, don't slow down the scale before, but go into it. When the theme comes, it's jubilo, it's jubil, jubilant. That's the way you have to play. You can't play the ta-ra-ra-ra. Not too soft either. Quite solid. And with tremendous joy. The whole thing is too slow. So starting with the bass, it's too slow. and it has vitality, it has joy, it has even a grotesque element. The way you play it is much too tame. It's a little crazy. Well, crazy in the crazy spirit. Do you think that this is not crazy? The very base you ever seen before Beethoven ever anything like that? Well, it's absolutely crazy. The whole thing, and with the whole idea to start with the base, it's already crazy. But anyway, you have to feel it a little bit like that, not just nice and well, just play it again
on the beat.
No, just change. Thank you. theme, you see, it must never sound tee da 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 dee, but tee da da dee. Also the end. That was makes this sort of breathless joy or whatever.
Would you break?
Yes, definitely. It was much better. Maybe now you were from the adue on a little fast. Exactly on the other side, on the other extreme now. And of course, it's not quite clear where you want to play staccato, where you want to play. Mm-hmm. For instance, the adue, we just said that. It doesn't say anything, but it doesn't say legato either.
You know, it's not in this edition.
You see?
I'm trying to think.
That's what I tell you about Mr. What's his name? Silent.
But
no? This is
Henry.
Oh, this is Henry.
Henry. I have. I'm in here.
This edition.
After the.
The
Buller
has the staccato.
Yes, but of course he was in this edition some hours, but you wouldn't take them for a tour text. No, he changes a little bit. But in this case, I think he's right. But Henley, it's incredible the things they do. And call it a text.
I
have talked so much with Dr. Zimmermann. You mustn't call them a text anymore. If I want a text, we want the exact picture the way the composer wrote. They think, for instance, if the phrasing is too crazy, we change it. That's not the joke for a text edition.
That is edited edition then.
Not
really,
the naturally.
Why don't
you?
But
is
there any more text edition?
Mr. Frank.
What about the sonatas? Is there
anything
there?
The sonatas is also a lot of change.
Yeah. Still the
practice. Still, if you can get it. It was reprinted about 5 years ago, the old text of the sonatas. In Germany, for some anniversary of some kind. You might probably be able to get it in Germany, if you look for it. Now, so there, please, staccato. That's it. The last one, you can play a little longer, it's in the phrase. Now, the Popo Adagio, there, and the two adue, make a little ritardando, like you do in the atrei. Otherwise, it sounds indifferent.
No, excuse me.
Yes.
In the bar just before that.
Yes.
Could you do a little more than
that? Yes, a little. We could do it. It was a little rushed. The way Bennett did. You know what? In the adue, the 16th. And then still in the Popo Adagio a little getting slower. Mm-hmm. That's important. Now, well, this is when it's
so important.
Well,
the theme is so important.
Yes, the theme is not there yet. Now, in this tempo now that you took now, do you have difficulties with the staccati, double thirds?
A little bit, yeah.
Hmm?
I'm not doing.
No, you don't have to. Yes. They are sort of vibrating. Do you have difficulties in this step or no?
No.
So you can do it. So let's flow into the theme just like this tremendous joy.
How would you use the paper?
I think I would take a pedal for the whole bar there at the fourth, eighth, lift it and take it again. After, then take it again in the thing. Take it again after striking the the first beat of the next bar. Off at the fourth and eighth.
Yeah.
And on after the first next bar.
The fifth bar. Or
of
every bar.
You want to catch the bass?
Yes, that's right.
Without catching the bass?
Oh yes, with catching the bass, but immediately after striking the beat or the fifth. But you have to, you better get it, catch it.
Yeah.
But
if it has
yes. Try this piece, maybe from the fermate. Please, in the first half of the scene, at the end, ta pam 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 pam, at the ta pam, staccato, put three dots there, because otherwise it becomes lame again, and not lame, tame. Yes. That's it. And at the end of the theme also. Please, no crescendo. And now, a little at the, when you reach the end of the theme, there you can sort of broaden a little, and also the three E flats. So that you make an upshoot there. And then take your time, and then start the variations. Must be quite clear that this up to there it's one thing, and now start the comment, the comments. Would you please do this from the trill, just to get the timing. There are little things more, but we think we could have more. Thank you. first variation is quite good. The basses are not, it should be a little more sonorous, more, a little more sound, like gongs. Yes, more intention, more purpose. The second variation is excellent. Not quite clear that die in the second section. You know that they should have a little more back accentuation on the first note of its triplet. In the cadenza, please don't play da 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 di da da da. It's not written like that. It's tara tira, no. Tira tira der tara tampa. That's quite intentionally written like that. Well, you can change fingerings now. It's too late.
I have fingerings.
What?
I have
fingerings. You know, it's better not to bother about it. Yes, the third variation is very good too. Only after the fermata, maybe you don't have it. Because in most editions it doesn't say. It starts after the fermata, piano. Rabbit, crescendo and sforzato on the C. Yes, it is sforzato.
Sforzato on the first well.
On the voice, on both. Tada! It's that. It's really start piano. Actually, the first piano in this variation. Really piano. After the sound. Why don't you take when you have ta ta tam three chords, same chord, one pedal, that's it. And before ta ta, take pedal everywhere. When you
have
both. You can't. No, actually, it's against the game. Ta ta. But the bass is, of course, not piano, but it's. That's it. Yeah, how good. It, again, it's the craziness that he doesn't want to accept. Let's see the word. They didn't like it. They thought probably Mr. What's his name? Title of the book before. And I noticed one thing also in the a quattro after the fermata, the two chords in the right hand and the deep, the two B's are very not stiff. You are never stiff anymore, but passive. I mean, you didn't lift the arm. That's the one place where you. Rah,
it should be. I was playing piano.
Then oh yes. Just the last chord. is of course not right. The Henley is just correct.
Yeah.
It's the on the second chord in the first bar. It's not E flat, but it's G and B flat. I had an argument the other day because the guy recorded it.
Yes.
And Henley is correct. Because they think it's more logical. Ti-ta-ra, ti-ta-ra.
Just
these two notes. This you have to correct, please.
I had the same argument
Just it's a curiosity, the E flat. Yes, not now, in November. the fourth is very good, the question is there. At the end, in the prima volta, you start too loud, you don't make a crescendo. The crescendo is prima volta.
Oh, I'm sorry, right.
No, that's the end of the variation. Prima volta. The end of the variation there. Don't you have the crescendo there? What do you
have?
Yes, you did there, you played, you just started forte right away instead of going into it. More or less, all right. Now after that, of course, we need a little time.
Yeah. Is the variation part to be slower?
You can do it. All the time where this tempo changes were made, but not written down. Crescendo in the first section, a little bigger, to sforzati, and then piano right away, and the upper voice in the right hand is clearer. Then in the Take Care, in the second section, that you don't accentuate the other voices when there is a spot sound. Times. Then after Fermata, the two sforzati are much weaker. You know that how relative the sforzato sign is. It's according to the level on which you do.
There's one more time which is also
where action?
After the piano, two bars.
But it's not only in
the
because did I, always with the logic. I mean, I brought Beethoven with, when it comes to interpretation with logic, it's just very strange. Anyway, because there's another piano, you see, probably just to warn the after Sforzati. But the sforzati are, they make it clear according to the level on which you are. You are. That's
perfect.
Okay. He says that this world is actually. Exactly as in the first edition. In the manuscript, probably he would be. What was that? The
end? The bericht.
From where?
From
Watts. Well, anyway, we probably he changed it. We might have changed it for the first edition, as always. You know, I don't think you should do it. Now, let's do the timing of to start the next variation. You need a little time. Uh-huh. This variation needs a little time to sort of peter out. Sort of a little quiet and sort of withdrawing and a little bit time, not slow as if you say slow is already too much, calmer. and the, with still the list, yes, like that. And then again with the staccato scale up. That's very good. The sforzato there should be a little more than you do in the finishing. But oh. In the finishing.
This
yes. Yes, yes. But in the first scene.
Yes, the first
scene. That's it. But it's comparatively weak, but still purposeful. It's a sort of yes. Do you do it? This next variation is very good. Yes, this forzati after the fermata, a little more. Why don't you play the E flat in the last but one bar? Staccato. What do you do? Yes. You need both times to try as just the last bar maybe, and because this the next variation needs time again. It was quite good. The tempo is very good, the feeling also. I would like to play the first E flat in the beginning of the variation, like a gong. And no, no. This is the original pedals are for the first bar, and then the second and third in one. And the fourth in one, and then nothing, and then seconda volta, a pedal that lasts until the, after the fermata. You have that?
Yeah.
Now, but after the fermata, you should lift the pedal after a little while and keep the chord only. With both hands. A flat in left hand must be clear. Thank you. 16th, the upbeat much slower. They are fast, of course, on the triplets. I mean, the way they should be. But if it's a sort of an impulse, perfect. I like very masculine.
Otherwise, this is so shocking.
Yes, when you must want to take the edges away of the shocks in Beethoven. That wouldn't be a reason, but on the contrary, it's very voluntarioso. How do you say that in other languages? Eigenwillig, willfulness of Beethoven is an important adaptation for this particular word. So it's in the spirit, but you take the responsibility. If they tell you why do you do that, you say, Mr. Rao told me, but I took the responsibility. But I like it. I like it very much. Now, it's a peculiar thing. You see, we should play the grace notes on the beat, which you actually do, but then you act the sforzati. Are actually meant for the grace. I take responsibility for that. After 15 years of...
Then one can be...
Yes, of course. Yes, because in the end... you take one-third, one-three on the two last... Yes, that's only... Now, it's fingerings, we are not going to speak about because it's too late. Otherwise, I would have told you that we have Tapim.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 5, natural, no? Yes. And the next one? That's if you work so hard, but then you see the skip is much bigger like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Four, five,
I think, yes. And now I would take, yes, 1, 2, 3, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, again, in the next bar. In the second bar. Yes. And then again, 4, 5, and 3, 5. That if once you have practiced it, forget about it now.
Yeah.
Just write it down for later. And also for the last, before the 3-5 and 4-5. And then again 3-5. Yes. And at the end, it's much more comfortable also if you play 3-5.
Yes,
they are
right.
Take two? This is otherwise very good in the spirit. Very much good. That's very, very, very good. Now I'll play the last bar and go on. A little more time than you did now. It sounded a little. You were stupid. Now I have an only German word occurred to me today.
Only
true that
I don't.
You
know.
Precipitous. You need a little breathing.
Mm-hmm.
Too much to earn. It's all of a sudden, you see, out of this lively variation, there comes a breath of the world all of a sudden. It's and then you go on. It's again crazy. Oh yes, exactly. Crazy in the good sense.
But in
insane, if you want it, insane. That's a, if that is a
crazy is already
destroyed. Well, because they say it is crazy, something like that. No, in this insane mind, if you like that better, insane.
Oh.
Exactly. Yes. Now, I have to say another thing. The crescendo is not big enough. 2 fortissimo, the last 16 so should be fortissimo already. Now, the 3 octaves are a little heavy. Heavy in the sense of tempo. Fine. Another little thing in the whole variation. Those staccato in the left hand is a little longer, almost portato. That's too much. Into the 2 forte E flat.
So the
portamento. The portamento which will get what you choose.
And especially you would post the left hand piano in the second part. In the first part,
not at all, so. The 40 were way better than this. It's easy chef. Change of that. Let's continue. Thank you. Same thing here, there, in the 11th variation. In the fifth bar, it's a lower voice. And then, yes, that's the funny strange thing. A bar later, we have the forte, it's the upper voice. F. Yes, from the F.
You started from the G before?
You could. But you don't start the forte there yet, no?
Yes, that's right.
So it's the forte is the
quiet.
Yes, that's correction.
But then you wouldn't do it.
Then please take the una corda for the pianissimo at the beginning of the section. And very tender, tita. So still, the first time it was still not piano. Yes. It's not too sharp. Yes, did you try 3-2-1-3? Work? It did work.
Yeah.
And why? Why?
Well, we have set the time for 3-2-1-3
is what. If you have it, yeah. Yes, I think it's better, it's safer. Don't weaken the last double third. Play the last bar and then the transition. It's a little too early. Crescendo, two crescendo bar, memory mistake or what?
No, that's actually,
this one
is very hard for me to do,
because
this is
kind of flashy. Oh, yeah. That's what. No, technically it's quite good, and I that's funny.
I think about it
on
that.
No, but I think it was a reading mistake. The fifth bar. The fifth bar.
No, those were.
Because I'm suspicious of the pedal there, the bass, also the last E flat of the word. But then you then pedal off and then nothing but the B flats in the right hand there. Now, I mean the timing.
I
have got it. Yes, it's perfect.
Is there
right
another tiny
thing? No, it's perfect. Thank you. beat? You see that the spitefulness of all this whole variation, the challenge, let's call it the establishment, challenge to the establishment,
it is what it is.
Actually. It is, comes only out if you play it on the beat.
Now, would it be louder? The A be louder than the B?
Equally loud. It becomes vulgar and loses its sense, its meaning.
What?
If you play it on before the beat.
Right. You would do it up or something?
Yes. Yes. And the two sudden pianos, prima volta and seconda volta, must start very soft. On the beat with exactly with the whole chord, not only the D left, but not too slow. Tara, still the idea of that's it. I mean, you can hesitate before the Armata, but the between the grace note and the main note, not too much time. Yes.
What do you play that?
I play now.
Well,
I play. 1-2.
One, two.
All the time.
Yes, all the time.
All the time?
Hmm?
All the time, 1-2?
1-2. Except, let's see, I do some little exception. Yes, funny, yes. I don't know why I do it, but it's somehow better in the hand. In the second section, 1-2, 1-2, 3-5. And there also 3-5. Yes.
All those 3-5.
All 3-5.
But most of
except if the first two, I mean.
Yeah. Right. 1-2 they subscribe to the piece of the third finger to prepare for the fourth.
And the bass.
But you can't change it now.
No, I can't. What about the bass?
Well, I play all the black keys with some and five. The white key. Yes, been doing.
All of them.
When you the closer one, the black keys. With the first one. But otherwise, the far away. Yes, it's too final thing.
Can you hold back a lot?
Yes, of course. Old music instruments, and the most interesting thing so much on this nonsense, for instance, of playing Beethoven in time and playing any music of the 18th century in time. They played as freely as anybody could imagine. And then they showed me the Beethoven piano, so it was very interesting. But I talk about that. Why did I think that from now?
Because of
playing
it, I said,
can
I hold back?
Oh, yes, it's good. It's a Beethoven. Freely we know it. If people say the Beethoven should be played exactly in time, it's ignorant. Just ignorant.
You may have very, very abruptly and different every time.
Every time, yes. Well, we know it from
Germany.
It's
even
great
for music.
What?
Even for Baroque music.
Even for Baroque music, it's ignorance to play it like that. Well, now let's...
So what about the tempo?
The tempo, the last time it was better, what?
Because at that tempo, I had a chance of getting all the notes.
No, it's a big thing.
It's all
these challenges of the... of those dissonances,
yeah.
And everything.
And you're trying to play faster.
No, and the note becomes again. Precipitous, you said. That's all the word. Big, very big, very, very big. Mm-hmm. Now we need a lot of time. Present that the first 8 bars, right hand, dramatically important, but the comment of the other hand is equally important, but the colors have to change. Sort of the static thing of the bass theme, and the other hand very espressivo and free. Then it changes over to the other thing. You know that every present? Well, everybody has it there. But then the next thing, left hand first, after that, left hand, and then right hand. Well, the thematic voice goes from the right hand, the 8 bars, to the left hand, the 5, then the left hand, and then the right again, because it was not clear at all. You don't know left, I don't know where you have understood what I mean.
Yes.
In the second half,
da da di da is the important thing. Yes. Now, 8 bars later, how much is it? Yes, 8 bars. There, the right hand takes over, and the left hand is only. It's the right hand. Right hand. Again. You know, I don't. I'm very tired. I can't explain this well anymore. This sort of static bass in the right hand when you start, and the espressivo left. After 8 bars changes. That's what I mean. It's a question of color to sound.
Registering.
The same thing later. Let's go on. Oh, I didn't say that for that.
No, because
my wording is difficult a little today. And important is one little thing here still, in the second section, that you play this staccato. Da-ram. Not too soft and a little purposeful. Da-ram. Not a little accent. Not too soft. No, it's too soft. That's it.
A little bit.
Yes.
Is this the sforzato? Is that? I haven't seen you the sforzato before. This
Yes. The sforzato is for the C flat.
This is notated in this way, so that it makes me think that possibly these two notes should last longer.
They last longer than
the ones.
Yes. Just play it like
that.
Yeah, it makes it awfully possible. No. That's good.
Except the last one.
They just know the rotations in one chord. Probably for because of the big skip. And then another thing that was not right, the crescendo in the fifth bar has to go all the way to the eighth, to the last note before the eighth bar.
The crescendo.
Later we have the next crescendo, the left hand is legato, like the right hand before. What do we have there? No, the fifth bar, the tararim, that's legato. The right hand, but not the left hand. Please.
Before,
yeah, do I have
them all legato?
Yeah, that's right. So the same thing.
Gotcha.
fighting for. Now let's play on and play to the very end. Just I would like just like to hear the end of this variation you just played before.
This one?
No, this one, the last one. Just to see how long you wait. Also make a lot of rubato in the passage, but the right tempo would be. Thank you. I think Melot, it's Melot speaking. More advisable to play in the Largo variation there. And also before. I don't laugh.
Is the
reverb
place? I got the idea or something.
Huh?
On your recording.
The old recording probably.
Yeah. That's original.
Like the new one. It's, I think it's... but it's, as we said, it's actually up to you.
Mm-hmm.
It's free. Then just a few things. I don't like the first 64th passage. Yes, exactly. You stop. Yes, and it's particularly in the beginning, and then when you come to the F there, a little hesitation too. And the rest was very good. The second time again, the same thing. But do it once for me. B flat, and in the left hand you do it so right there, legato. Now why don't you do it the first time? Or do you have there also contatti or something? The first time, 1, 2, 3, 4. The fifth time.
Right
one. That's right. But
which I didn't do. I was
trying to. Oh, I see. The left hand should be legato there. The fifth, 1, 2, 3, 4, the fifth bar, the body, largo one.
So you really hear?
That's it. And then afterwards, please, in the second section, those staccati. No, for any reason in the world, crescendo the first time. In the second time, a terrific crescendo.
Mm-hmm.
Again afterwards, when you have that 464th. You trouble there with the.
I just changed the. Oh. Just change it.
Okay. Then you
do you put yourself in the beginning for that?
The first one with the fourth, and then the 1, 4, 2, 5, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2. Although I don't like it too much.
Which thing is going to use now? Okay, as you suggest.
It seems to be very, very wise. You feel me?
Yes.
Very, very wise. Probably when you practice it, it will come out very well. Write it down because it's quite interesting. It's quite very interesting. Kaiserliche und königliche. Fingersatzmacher. Thank you. vibrate. And then another thing, experience. Not there. Just for those four notes, I mean. Make them easier. And then another thing is, prepare when you are playing the single voice. Already stretch your hand to get to the B flat. Yes. Then the fourth forzati after the arpeggio. First of all, the arpeggio is to make a crescendo already in the arpeggio instead of starting it afterwards. Yes, from there. Again, where you have the double notes and with the fingering, mm-hmm. It's piano, please. Don't make any crescendo of any kind. Stay piano. The second one, the more. Then after the arpeggio and the 16th staccati, crescendo, and then we have the fourth forzati. Even if you play the staccato and the bass, a little more pedal.
I could wedge.
What?
I put a wedge. Not the staccato, the other one, the wedge.
Ah, yes, yes.
More pedal on that
one. Yes. Well, here we have this only the second time in this edition. Mm-hmm. A dot on the wedge. Very violent as you did, it was very beautiful, but a little long, a longer pen. That's it. Now the coda, sort of serioso, and into that doesn't fit the Chopinesque kind of rubato that you made at the end of the second bar. You know how much I am for freedom. But this kind of rubato was a little Chopinesque. I would like even that note a little heavier. Every note a little more weight. Yes. Hold back a little bit, yes. It's fine. It's much more beautiful. It's sort of a... Yes, elegant. That's what I wrong part to play. Then, of course, you know all the memory mistakes you did in the two last parts before that.
But
wait a second, here, please,
you place the B,
yes.
That you have it
in
your edition,
I think,
or to correct
the fifth part. Yes, I thought it was a casual mistake.
Yeah, it's that was memory, because it's B in the next measure.
And these two bars, quite, you know, largo, Beethoven largo style. Rust with a tremendous expression. Particularly the second bar with the crescendo.
You said once we had the ending bar, it was rushing. You said this
resignation. Yes. After the sforzato. Resignation, of course. No, I meant to mean that. That's fine. But that they also, that the ghost for that part too. But we meant, now they are the second part.
Yes,
you did. Yes, you did. It was so much slower. Yes. in the you have the tari in the base. Sort of, and you even if you have made a big rallentando in the bar before, pick up a little bit. Now the shoe is tying a little bit fast. And more than fast, it's unsteady. And this is a piece of music that needs a tremendous rhythmic steadiness, and firmness, and interior firmness. Hmm? And another thing that I don't like at all. I like the liveliness of the fugue. Do you have it there? The Beethoven didn't write anything there.
It's
more lack of steadiness. When you have the sudden piano, for instance, then please sustain the notes that have to be sustained. When you can come after that, about 8 or 10 bars afterwards. Yes. And then afterwards. Yes. That's it. And for the double low notes, their vibration. You'll never get it in a fast tempo if you don't vibrate. The again hesitation. Ta. Yes. But don't, after the hesitation, don't get slower. Yes. Now, a little more purpose, sort of, again, insane. And all of a sudden this beautiful theme comes against the grain and staccato, almost like making fun of this thing, of the expression of the theme. Yes, where the main problem. Again, you, of course, you have fallen into the F sharp, disgusting sharp. And then they correct, it's also a correction. Again, because of logic.
Oh, no. Wrong note?
Yes, it's F. Or it's been F.
Oh. Even though the other times.
Yes, but that's again, logic doesn't, that is. It's not important in Beethoven. I mean, to the yes. Enough. You see, the thing is, in this sort of wrong note that this F means has a meaning, and then, then when you bring the A flat. The upper voice, 4 bars later, it's a steigerung. Strengthening, yes. But you have to have the two things together. Yes. But please, that you have to change. Can you do it? It's what, just one more? And then a little careful with the scales, the bass, the
vibrative.
Yes, but those who can vibrate and with a pedal a little bit carefully. Take pedal, but not, but change it more. And again, when this umkehrung, the inversion starts, we need a lot of time. Yes. Now this one little thing never comes out. In the 13th inversion, the 4th inversion, the 3rd bar, it's in the left hand. What fingering, what do you take on the B flat? Thumb and then you don't take the thumb and change to 5?
Yes,
that's
under. No, I'm
playing
with the D with the left hand.
Oh, my goodness. But then you can't play the inversion legato. Should be. Well, anyway, you can't change it anymore. I think that's the one to but for later. 1-5, but very sudden, very fast change so that you are in time for the thumb for the A flat. Yes. And yeah, the end is very beautiful. I mean, the climax of the fugue is very good. Then the andante con moto. But also don't forget the phrasing again.
Is the skill all right?
Yes.
Tired?
Absolutely.
My thing is that
this
is you're tired. That's why you can't sing. That's why you're singing the
thing. Yes, exactly. Yes. Just give me what, 2 or 3 bars of the theme. But without any rush this time, particularly the beginning. Yes, but now the whole tempo is too slow. Yes, fine. Now we have the molars. Please, just bring out in the left hand just the 4 first. Not any further, because the rest of those notes are filling notes, not thematic. You brought out yes, I know, but we have to be rather careful so they don't come out.
So I don't have to.
No.
Not at all.
Not at all. Not at all. Just filling. What about the trill? Oh, you played with it. Yes, you didn't do it this time. And there we need the inversion in the left hand very much.
And then again, not so much as the outside.
Not too much, no.
The trill.
And then what?
I'm trying to play 8 notes.
What?
I'm trying to play 8 notes,
yes. Yes, it's all right. It shouldn't be too bad because of the general mood. What do you do in the last, the ending of this?
Of the ending of the trill?
Yes.
But at the 5th bar, I changed the trill so that it's now
yes.
One and
yes.
Instead of the
other. Oh, yes, it's all right. But then, you play the 16th. Everybody plays the 32nd. Correct?
No,
did it himself?
I don't know.
And then after that,
yes.
After that, please, exactly this rhythm. No crescendo, sudden fortissimo. Crescendo, sudden piano. And then they start the piano, and then the next trills was very good. They also, I think you started with the upper note, didn't you? The low next trills, no?
The first one. No, I'm trying to
yes.
Accent
about it. Yes, but then this now. I don't hear enough the bass, the next thing in the left hand. They corrected it also. Come here and look.
Most editions corrected in the edit. Most editions not correct all of this.
That's it.
It's
not it. From here on, it's TIE.
This is the way most editions have it.
Before. And up to and then it up to this last one. That's it. So much beautiful, more beautiful.
Nice.
And then
it's a
of the intention of
the
first phrase in before the preceding thing.
It's a what?
A proof that he meant the other phrasing.
Right.
It wasn't just a conventional. Now, after that, the piano crescendo forte, from there on, real crescendo. You have to keep that apart, please. Before, when you had it in the right hand, it was piano and sudden fortissimo, and piano crescendo and sudden piano. This time it's all the time piano crescendo forte.
Now should I do it in both hands?
Yes, absolutely. More in the left. Yes. Too much there when you stop now. It sounds a little alright, but not too much. It sounds as if you were trying to make the skip easier. Don't play. I want to explain you something. It is ti ra ra upper voice ra and well, then what? Yes, but I don't hear it. You took a faster tempo right away, which is not right. Gradually, moving.
Should be a
religion. Yes, almost. Not too much at any that you could call it in accelerando. Ravivando more. The whole thing, you see, from the end of the fugue is, to first it's just like, not meditation is not right, it's a very quiet start, dreaming, and then gradually it gets a little involved, not involved, not a word, it gets more fluent, and the tempo gets faster and faster, but so gradually that you only feel this, this alive, and more alive. Thank you. Yes. That don't have
over
the. In particular at the end, but you have to finish with a tremendous assertion, self-assertion. What do we have difficulties there?
Yeah, some
what finger is it?
Just
yeah. But then you better do it like this. That's it. Down with the thumb and up. The thumb and then you sort of jump on the reflex. No, that's not good.
They must somewhere have reasons.